to Total Divas. I'm Renee Young. This is Miss Alicia Fox. This was quite the episode of Total Divas.
I know, it was so spicy.
A lot of action happened. So what we do here is we recap Total Divas, which airs on E! Sunday nights at 10 Eastern, 9 Central. We have a lot of things to cover here, lots of topics. So let's get into the weekly Diva Dish. The things that we're covering here are relationships on the rocks.
So John basically handed me a paper that I have to sign about living in his home.
I've been thinking about your paper.
It's something that's necessary.
Being practically unpacked, I felt like you were being selfish. And you even told me that the reason why you didn't give it to me before is because you were afraid I'd say no.
Okay, so Nikki and John, we finally get to a bit of a conclusion here with the two of them. They left us on the hook with episode 2 just to figure out what was going to happen with this whole cohabitation agreement.
Yes.
What do you think of how it all played out?
I'm actually really proud of Nikki.
Yes.
Kept cool and calm, you know. What a classy lady.
I feel like, you know, taking the time to talk to Bree, to talk to her mom, and the fact that her mom was so cool about the whole thing.
Now, his attorney who drew this up is there to protect them. Now, understand that this document is all based on past experiences that John has had.
Like, she's a classy lady.
If I were to call my mom about that, she'd be like, what are you talking about? There's no way. Like, she would go off on me, and it would be very useless. All around.
Yeah.
All bad news. All right, topic number 2, relationship on the rocks. We are going in the bedroom.
When was the last time you gave him some? Get that man some cookie.
I see nothing, hear nothing. I'm going to see her today, but should I say something? No.
So she's got her issues in the bedroom with Vinny. She's not really feeling it. Maybe doesn't want to get down.
Get down.
But she, you know, she took the steps to go to the therapist.
I'm putting 110% in on this therapy thing.
Oh, okay.
That's the number one weapon.
Look, I'm going to really try to get outside of the box, okay?
Okay, cool.
Okay, ready? Close your eyes.
Okay.
Come on, go this way. Come on.
It was going to you.
Faster.
Kudos to Vinny for trying. Kudos to Cameron for being open-minded about
it. And you know, it seemed like they got the ball rolling once they got into the whips and such. Anyways, moving on. Topic number 3, relationship on the rocks in the ring.
How would you feel if I was in there like this with Jonathan? Let's go, Jonathan. You are looking at him like you want him.
No.
You have a reputation for being shady. You do.
I'm engaged. I'm getting married. Maddie, honestly, you're taking this to a whole nother level. I promise you, like, I would never in a million years.
I don't trust you.
Bit of an issue here in the ring. So Tyson Kidd, TJ, Natty's husband, rolling around in the ring with Eva Marie, who has developed, you know, a bit of a reputation already. Right. What do you think of what happened in the ring the other down at the Performance Center?
Okay, honestly, TJ doesn't have anything else to do with his time other than hang out with Eva.
He could be busier, I'm sure. Eva wants to learn, and she's there to work with TJ. But do you think that Natalia overreacted?
I think it's that Eva wants to learn, but she has a million superstars to pick from.
Fandango was there.
Exactly.
Fandango was there, you know?
Twerk it with Fandango.
Okay.
Not a married man.
Which would probably maybe upset Summer Rae, but that's a whole other story. Let's bring on our guest for this episode, Miss All Red Everything, Eva Marie.
Hello.
Hi. How are you?
Mwah.
Thank you for coming on our show again.
Yes, thank you for having me.
Distance there. Okay, what is your opinion from what happened with you and TJ and with Natalia reacting the way she did toward you?
I mean, I think it's a bit crazy considering TJ was at the Performance Center. He'd just come off his knee surgery. I would be a fool not to take him up on his offer. I mean, I'm the new kid on the block trying to learn, trying to get ahead.
Did he offer or you asked him to do it?
He was walking by the ring, and I took him up on, you know, he said, hey, do you want some help? And I said, sure.
TJ, I want you to make me like Natty and like you.
Take time. I think you knew where you were going with all this. And what would that be?
I mean, the fact that TJ's married, therefore he's unattainable. Maybe that's a little dig at Natty. I'm just saying.
I think it's funny because Natty shouldn't even be sweating it at all, considering she's a married woman, and she was going on dates with Jarrett. I'm clearly engaged. I'm good. I don't need another man.
Excuses. I'm sorry. I don't know.
Maybe you have a little problem with me. I see the last 2 weeks you give me lose it. I mean, what's your problem?
I don't have a problem. I'm just saying that you just rightfully deserved it. I mean, out of all the girls on the show, they all have the opportunity of being on my lose it list. I'm just saying that.
I feel like now's a prime opportunity.
Just hop in line maybe, with everybody else.
Maybe we can get to our soundbite winner of the week. You are our honored guest on our show here today. So you can take it away here and let us know who won the soundbite from last week.
You guys voted all week, and your soundbite winner is...
A.K.A. the space between is the perineum.
But the chode.
Feel as if public education has failed you.
All right, now it's the time of the show where we get into the sound bites from this week.
Well, you know, last night I went and got some burrito from here, babe. Carne asada burrito. Oh, my God, that thing was the bomb.com.
Vinny was really on fire this episode.
Are you really jealous of Fandango?
I'm not at all jealous. If he wants to dance all day and night, wear little sequin pants...
Please don't be mad at me, TJ.
You're the one who got all mad and all hostile.
Soundbite number three from one half of the Bellas, Miss Bree Bella.
Wow, it's hot out. Like a sweaty mustache.
Log on to WWEDivas.com to vote for who you want the soundbite winner of the week to be next week. And again, at the end of the season, we're going to be crowning the king and or queen of the soundbites. So get on there and vote. And also make sure to use the hashtag TotalDivas. And now to add a little more spice to the spicy episode with the love it or lose it. This week, I love the fact that John Cena went the old-fashioned way and gave Nikki a phone call. John Cena proved that he was not a coward, that he was a relationship champion.
Did you know my name?
Ginger Mahal.
Did she say Ginger?
Congratulations to Eva for not striking out three times in a row on my lose it category. This week, it goes to Daniel Bryan.
Hello? I'm actually in the middle of having lunch with Bree. I can do it if you guys need me to.
Work is great, but it can wait. But love, who knows how long it will stay at the table.
Next week on Total Divas.
I think that you could make a great WWE superstar.
Give me everything you got. Go. You want an opportunity to come here and be paid to do this?
I can help you redecorate the house.
No candles, no personal photos.
I can't do this anymore.
It's like I'm living in a museum.
Hey, Matt!
I'm moving in that party tonight.
What the f*** is going on?
I live here.
I live here too, so what's the problem?
Where the f*** am I going?
Where are you going?
Lots more juicy stuff coming up here on Total Divas, so make sure to catch that Sundays on E! At 10 p.m. Eastern Time. And then me and Foxy will be back here again next week to recap it all. See you later.